Sleigh ride is. Well, I think you got to learn a little bit more. Give you a quick update on that. First of all, way back in the days of Moby Dick, way up in Nantucket, on the east coast of Massachusetts, they go out in the big ships and they go out looking for the big whale.
Julio, can I get some water on this lift?
They go out in the ocean to look for the big whale. The big ships go out there, and then they come across the whale who's sleeping.
Okay, cheers, everybody.
I'm just waiting for Harry to do his thing. It's all right, Harry. Take your time right away.
Just a sip.
All right, I'm gonna start again. Nantucket sleigh ride. Big ships, way back 200 years ago, the whaling industry off in Nantucket. And they go out in these big ships. When they see a big whale out there, they jump into these long boats. The crew, I guess about five guys, jump into these long boats. And they paddle out to the whale, and they attach the harpoon to a rope. And the rope is attached right to the boat, to the long boat. So what happens is they pull up on the whale and they hit him with a harpoon. The harpoon, again, is attached to the boat. And the whale looks around and says, what's going on? They hit him with another one. At this point, the whale is getting really pissed. Turns around and says, I'm going to take these guys for a ride. And that ride that this whale takes them for is called the Nantucket Sleigh Ride, because he takes off out in the ocean, way over 50 years, the waves are smashing everywhere, and they're holding on for dear life because they're attached to the whale. The rope is attached to the harpoon. The harpoon is now in the whale, and the whale is going to take them deep. He's going to dive, and he knows they're going with him. And this is symbolic of the rock and roll industry that was going down back 50 years ago, when all the record companies would say, go for the big one, boys and girls. Go out there. I don't care what happens to you. Go for the big one. We want a big record. That's the big one. And all these bands that go out there looking to get the big bucks, the big gold records, they don't know if they're ever coming back. You know, they're out there promoting and TV and whatever you call it, partying, etc. They don't know if they're ever coming back. This song is dedicated to all the brothers and sisters in the music business who went after the big one and never came back. It's called the Nantucket Sleigh Ride.
Thank you.
We're gonna have something special now.
I know I'm gonna repeat myself, but when you get to be as old as I am, that's what happens. You repeat yourself. These guys, the Bobos, are the very best human beings around today that are playing the kind of music that's wonderful. And I happen to be very fortunate to be playing with them. From Harry, Connie, all these guys are great. What happens is sometimes when you go into and travel, people ask a lot of questions, and they want to know. They just want to know after 50 years, like, really, do you need the money that bad? No, it's not about the money. Are you that addicted? Yes, you get addicted to playing. It doesn't make any difference about that. The bands that are out there right now, the big ones, you know who they are. They really don't need the money. But they need to perform. They've been on the road for, go ahead, give it up. This is true, this is what they're, fucking hey, I clap and I got water in my hand. The thing is, it's pretty, 50 years of going through what I would consider to be old school rock and roll. It doesn't just go away. You can't go retire and paint houses and shit like that. You gotta do it, it's in your bone. And it's bands like the Stones and the Who, who's ever alive, to get on the stage in front of people like you, they have to get on the road to meet people like you. And that's exactly what's happening with us this week. We are doing this tour out of nowhere. We had the agent just call, let's go play. And we wanted to play here in Stockholm, and we wanted to play in northern Scandinavia. You gotta play. And I said, you think about it, as when I was playing drums in a local band in Montreal way back in the 60s, they had what they called the British Invasion. You may have heard the story, it's in the book, which I'll show you. Anyways, they used to come to Montreal, the Who, Hendrix, Cream, in the 60s, to come over to do their first tour. They weren't heroes, they weren't, they were gonna do the first tour. But they had to get to Montreal to get their visas, all right? That's part of the music business, you have to have a visa. So they get to Montreal, and of course they booked the Montreal for them so they can play the show, and they wait around for a couple of days, and they get the visas. While they were in Montreal, though, we had a rehearsal place deep down in the city below one of the hairdressers, and we used to bring these guys. Between you and I, they had a few pills in them, and they were up for days at a time, and they're saying, what are we gonna do now? We're in Montreal, where the hell is this? We take them down to our rehearsal place on Côte-des-Neiges. It was a lot of fun. The Trogs came down there, Hendrick came. Everybody came to play because it was 4 a.m. Where are you gonna play? And you're revved right up, you've been traveling. But that's not the point. The Who were playing the Forum, and we, our local band was opening up for them on the show. And this goes back to when the Who were, they were breaking up their equipment on stage, crashing everything. And it was pretty wild. People didn't know what was going on then. It was like, Keith Moon's blowing all his drums around, Peter Townsend smashing the amps. It was wild. And at the end of it, everything gets quieted out. And well, I went around to the back of the stage, and I went onto the stage where I kept my drums. And I looked down, and there's this beautiful jacket with, all these gold things and knitted stuff, has the British flag. And I look at it, and I said, this could fit me, And I said, okay. And I said, okay, I guess Keith doesn't want it. He threw it out, and it was under the stage. Anyways, I go back, I put it under my coat, and I go back to the dressing room. And I say to the guys in the band, guess I got Keith Moon's jacket. And they go, what the fuck's that all about? What are you talking about? You took his jacket? Well, it was under the stage. Just at that point, screaming next door in the hockey locker room where they were changing, screaming, I gotta get back to the stage. They left me jacket on the stage. My grandma made me jacket for the tour and I've gotta get to the... And he's not wearing any clothes. He's all undressed and he's trying to get back to the stage and they're holding him back. Security guy said, you can't go out there, Keith. You're not wearing anything and you don't want to go out there. I gotta get back to the stage. My grandma made it. You gotta get me jacket. Anyway, as he's walking by, I said, Keith. He said, no autographs now. I'm going to get me jacket. My grandma made me jacket. I'm going to get my jacket. And I said, here it is. Here's your jacket, Keith. And he goes, oh, shit. And he looks at me with those big eyes. I tell you, we're talking big eyes. And he looks at me and he comes at me. And I said, he grabs me by the coat. And he goes, you've got me jacket, don't you, mate? I love you, I love you. This is me grandma's jacket. She made it for me. I love you, I love you. I love you. And he gives me a great big kiss. Bang! On the mouth. I said, okay. And he says, I'll never forget you. He loved it. I'll never forget you. So he turns around, he walks off, and I don't know what I was thinking. I said, Keith, I was gonna steal it. I don't know what the fuck I was thinking. Anyways, at that point, he turns around, and this time he really gives it to me. And he grabs me again, and he looks me in the eyes. But you didn't steal it, did you, mate? You gave it back to me, and I love you even fucking more. And I get another big kiss right on the lips. Bam! At that point, I thought we had a relationship. It's a true story. It's a true story. I hate to do this, but when you're on the road, you do what you do. So this particular story, along with other ones, they're true. They're serious as a heart attack. This is a book that Tuli Tzekela and I wrote over the COVID time, and it was a few years ago. And it's the story of a musician in Montreal growing up during the heyday of rock and roll. And I think there's a couple left, whatever. And so I want to continue the story. I don't like doing this, but my mother says, sell. Anyway, so what happens, I fell in love with Keith Moon. Okay, that's all. We'll cut right to the chase. I love Keith Moon. I love the drums. I love the whole thing. I look at him. It's a joy. He's like watching a circus, you know? And I fell in love with drums. And that was it. But at the same time, I'm talking here. You want to get up and talk? Come on up and talk. Let me just finish this story, because it gets better. I think. Anyway, so at the same time I was writing in the band Energy that I was with, and I happened to be very lucky, because as things went on, Energy songs showed up on the Mountain Records, and it was a financial pleasure. Point being is, I think Bob Dylan, he had a record out called Nashville Skyline. And it was a beautiful, I fell in love with that rating, and I always loved. So I was conflicted, ladies and gentlemen. I had the drums, and I had the rating, and Keith Moon, Bob Dylan. I'm not comparing myself, I'm just saying this is what was in my head. Anyways, I put together this song that I've been working on for over 40 years. About 40 years, I'm gonna put it together for you right now. Hold on, I'll be right back. I'm going over to see my all-consuming mistress. Before I start, I just want to toast you guys again for listening. That's wonderful. Thank you. All right. We'll be right back. time. I dressed so fine, I threw the bums a dime. I was in my prime. People call saying, beware, Corky, you're bound to fall. I thought they were all kidding me. I used to laugh about everybody that was hanging out. Now I don't laugh so loud, now I don't seem so proud. About having to be crouching my last meal. How's it feel? How's it feel? Be out on your own. No place to call home. Like a rolling stone. Never compromise with the mystery tramp, and now I realize he ain't selling any alibis. You know what I mean? No, he ain't selling alibis. As I look into the back of his eyes, as I look into the back of his eyes, as I look into the back of his eyes, and I said, do you want to make a deal? How's it feel? How's it feel? Turned around to see the frowns and the jugglers and the clowns when they all did tricks for me. Never understood it ain't no good to let other people get their kicks for me. I used to ride on a chrome horse like a diplomat. I carried on my shoulders a Siamese cat. Aimed it hard when I discovered that. Not really where it's at. After he had taken from me. After he had taken from me. Everything. 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 He could steal. How's it feel? How does it feel? How does it feel? To be out on your own. No direction home. Like a rolling, like a rolling, like a rolling stone. Hey. Princess on the steeple and all the pretty people. They're all drinking, they thought it could be. They all thought they had it made. They're exchanging all kinds of gifts, all kinds of gifts and things. I'm gonna take this diamond ring. I'm gonna pawn it. You know what happened? I used to be so amused at Napoleon in rags and the language that he used. I go to him now. He calls me. I can't refuse. When I've got nothing. I've got nothing. I've got nothing to lose. I'm invisible now. I'm invisible now. I've got no secrets. I've got no secrets to conceal. I'm invisible now. I've got no secrets. How does it feel? Hey? How does it feel? Be out on your own. Like a complete unknown. Like a rolling stone. Yeah, like a rolling stone. A rolling stone. Everybody sing along. Rolling stone. Like a rolling stone. Everybody. Like a rolling stone. Like a rolling stone. Ready? Like a rolling stone.
holy stuff.
Yeah.
Holy stuff.
Go down south. You know, when you go down south, where do you go, right? You go to Mississippi. That's where we go. We're going to roll on down. We want to do a song at the end of this Rolling Stone thing. Take it down. Take it down. We're going to do